Isn't it so great that we get to connect with people and share and exchange and shoot the breeze and...
I don't know what that means, shoot the breeze, but it sounds good. Shooting the breeze.
Shooting the breeze is a term where you're just going back and forth with someone and idling the time away.
Gee, your dialect just changed.
You don't know what idling means?
Idling? Idling the time. Nope. Sorry.
It's like the nothingness, like the, you know, when you shoot the breeze, you're just shooting the air.
You shoot nothing.
Yeah.
Shoot in the air. It's very violent, though. It doesn't seem relaxing at all, shooting
the
breeze.
No, it's fun. It's an ideal life when you've got moment to shoot the breeze with someone.
With somebody. Hey, Jackie, you want to go shoot the breeze? Oh, hell yeah, I'm going to come shoot the breeze with you. Is that?
No. Oh. I love you. Damn. You know, every time you do like an American accent, you always sound like you're from like 1975. You know?
Come on, Jackie.
Like Grady.
Let's shoot the breeze. Well, I'm still learning, you know?
Yeah, you don't have any of these references. Everybody thinks, you know, he just knows stuff, but he doesn't know anything about the Jeffersons or Sanford and Son, none of that.
Nope.
Shooting the breeze. Everybody knows what shooting the breeze is.
Yeah,
what do they say in
Germany,
like when you're relaxing, doing nothing?
Wir machen überhaupt nichts. Wir liegen nur rum.
What does that say, translation?
We don't do anything. We just lay around.
Well, we're ready to do more than lay around today. We have fun with rapper Lil Jon.
Celebrity chef Nadia G, who's with us today.
Yes.
And for my favorite show in the whole world, Ray Donovan. You guys watch Ray Donovan?
Yeah.
Incredible show. Actor Dash Mihok is here. Bunchy in the house. The Emmy nominations were announced. And the show Transparent actually received the nomination. Plus their...
For best comedy.
Yes, and the best actor... Jeffrey Tambor was also...
Yes, that's great news, yes. And some other notables, Viola Davis, Taraji P. Henson.
Which is amazing because it's the first time two African-American actresses were announced in the same category.
Yes, for outstanding actress in a lead drama, you know, in a drama. This is huge. Empire, interestingly enough, did not get a Best Series nomination. I don't know why. Mm. Because, you know, that they broke all kinds of records, and it's just an incredible show. But Game of Thrones, I am a Game of Thrones fan. Mm-hmm. 24 nominations.
Wow. That's
crazy.
And what is that?
That's my Game of Thrones position I'm taking in the house now.
Help, please, send help. But, you know, my good buddy Will Forte was nominated as well for... Best comedic actor in for Last Man on Earth.
Which my husband is also a co-star.
That's right.
You play a bad boy in that. And all the girls love you. They say that women are biologically drawn to the bad boy.
Why is that?
The
strongest sperm? Is that it?
You're
laughing.
But, you know, I think that's true. Like, it's the alpha male. Like, this is the guy that's going to protect me and the kids.
I will protect you.
You know, but it's interesting. It's like, we don't want the bad guy in the relationship, though. Right? We might want him in the bedroom.
You guys are hypocrites, ladies.
I think I found a nice combination.
Of a bad boy and a good boy?
Yeah.
How am I good and how am I bad?
You're good because you're good. You're a good person. And
I take that, thank you.
Yeah, your heart is good. Mm-hmm. You're bad, and your bad is good too.
Yeah. Oh, that's dangerous. I like it.
From the male point of view, why are women attracted to the broken guy, the damaged guy?
Because they want to fix us. You guys want to fix, you like projects.
We like projects.
Right?
Who am I going to fix today?
You just like projects.
We like to rescue.
Yeah.
Yeah, and save. We do. Yeah, it's and the maternal then, you know, instinct,
when we
I
give
think.
In, we say, hey, okay. And we just lean back. And that's it.
Hey, Jackie, want to shoot the breeze?
Well, you know, the key is to recognize the bad traits and then, you know.
Phase them out?
What? No, I think we have to decide, we have to avoid them. You know, weigh your options. You know, you have to project into the future and say, is this somebody I want to leave my kids alone with?
I believe that.
Right? Think about how that changes things. You're out on a date and you're like, could I go to work and leave the kids home?
With the bad boy.
With the daddy. With this is their daddy? No.
The bad baby daddy.
Yes. It's just the way we are. I mean, women have projects and men just don't understand. And that's not the only thing men don't understand.
Oh, really?
Yeah, there are things that only women understand that men don't.
Like what?
When we worry that if you let the guy pay, he'll, you know, expect something in return.
Oh, come on. Are you serious?
Yeah. You guys never go through that.
Okay, so, all right. What I don't like about this is the sense of entitlement. Because for a guy, there's nothing worse when you go to a restaurant and the woman automatically expects you to pay.
I don't see what's wrong
with
that.
And I don't even want nothing from
you. Okay, you got three guys on your side.
That's my man right there. Who else got my back? Who else got my back?
I'm not paying for dinner. I'm not paying for dinner. I'm not. That's, you can't. Okay. No!
Wow. This is very interesting to me because you ladies are hypocrites.
Why?
On the one hand, you're desperately holding on to the traditional values.
Yes.
And the gender-based. What? And then on the other hand, you say, I can open my own door. You pay for my dinner. What? Okay. You can't have it both ways. Okay?
Yes, we can.
If you want to hold on to traditional, I can't even say it, to traditional values.
When has a woman ever expected you to pay and you know?
All the time.
Give me one example.
Like you yesterday? So what?
What are you talking about?
So what?
Like before we
you
were
don't
married.
Even leave the house with a wallet anymore.
No,
you have no connection to your wallet.
What about before we were married?
Before we were married.
Was there any situation where you were in the dating scene hanging out with girls? I'm sure you were like
it happens
out with
all
Patrick.
The okay, I'll give you one example. I was in Miami, my brother and myself, and it was before we were married.
I already don't like this story.
We met a group of ladies that were sitting around a table having dinner. Coincidentally, we walked in that place.
You didn't set this date
up? No, it wasn't set up. It was six ladies, and my brother knew two of them.
Okay.
So we walked in a restaurant, and my brother goes, hey, look at that, hey, what's up? And we went over there, and we
sat
down.
Did you pull up chairs to the table?
No, we sat down on the next table, turned our chairs around so we were closer to them, and we were just chatting away. Drinking water.
No.
I didn't order anything.
Your brother did not order a Coke?
We had already eaten.
Okay.
So we went there, we sat down, had our water. 20 minutes later, we get up to leave, and one of the ladies gets up from the table, chases after us, and goes to me, we were thinking that maybe you could take care of the bill. I was like, what? I was like, are you serious?
That's what you get for hanging out with hoochies. That's what you get. All right. You know, love isn't always easy. So much so that a study found that most people only say I love you in a romantic way to only three people in their lives.
Three people?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
How many people have you said I love you to?
Just you. No, but look, women have their own way of counting past lovers. With like temporary amnesia, you know, you make your own rules.
Well, some stuff doesn't count.
He doesn't count. He doesn't count. That one. Well, he really didn't do it. Well, he didn't really take his clothes off. Well, okay, you have told me about a few people, but then you left out a lot.
Like
we went to New York. Okay, we went to New York one time. Went to a club at night, and the doorman opens the velvet rope, spots my wife, and goes, "Ooh, hey, Nikki Love."
like, whoa, 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 hold on a second. Nikki Love? What is that Nikki Love? And then this one over here goes, hey, that's just the guy from, you know, from way back. So I don't even want to hear
no,
how many people.
There was a study here. There was a study somewhere.
Okay.
It said that men are more likely to stay in touch with the former exes and women are less likely. Wait, let me get it right. There's a study here that says men are more likely to stay in touch with former partners than women. Right? And we're not likely to speak to our exes. You did us wrong, boom, bye. Right?
Bye, Felicia.
No, bye, Fernando. But no, you guys.
No,
I'm gonna interrupt you because you and the phone and the oh my gosh, it's been so long, Boris, I haven't seen you. Yeah.
When you were together with somebody,
no.
Just because you break up, you're not compatible
we
anymore. Doesn't mean that it's a bad person.
I got a New York story real quick. We went to New York, and we were having dinner, the family, everybody, and the phone buzzed, and he was at the bathroom, so I kind of just looked. And it said, okay, from a supermodel that he used to date, gorgeous girl.
She's beautiful on the inside.
Yeah, okay. And she was like, oh my God, I heard you were in town. I miss you so much. There's so much to catch up on. How's life? And I was like,
this is how she sounded?
Yes.
Via text.
And I picked up the phone and I said, I'm great. I'm here with the whole family. If you want to get together, Nicole and I and the kids would love to meet you for lunch.
She really did.
I really did.
Yeah.
Love, Boris.
True story.
Yeah.
And then she told me like weeks later.
I don't think the girl ever texted back.
No, never again. And
never
it was
again.
Like 6 years
See,
ago.
Ladies, I handled it, right?
Sorry.
Yeah, I handled it. We have to take a break. When we come back, we'll turn it up with Little John! And his son, DJ Young Slade!
What's up, it's your boy Lil John. This is my son,
Young Slade.
We're about to go on the Boris and Nicole show.
Yeah!
The Grammy Award-winning hip-hop superstar and proof that you can have a hard edge in the industry while remaining a great dad.
He's here today with his record-spinning son who's following in his footsteps. Please help me welcome Lil John and his son, DJ Young Slade! Stuff right here, okay? Yes. To see a father and son share such a powerful medium like music together. I'm really honored that you guys came here together.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah. So, DJ Young Slade, do you remember the moment that you wanted to do this?
Yeah. My mom was sick, and my dad, it was like, hey, come to this party with me. I'm DJing tonight. And so I think I was 11, so I was just like, oh, okay, let's do it. And
so, it wasn't a party, it was an award show. Okay. Let me set the record straight.
Yeah,
it was a skateboarding award show for Trans World Skateboarding, and afterwards they had like a little party in the back.
Okay.
So we went to the award show, and then
it was appropriate for you to bring your kid. Yes,
it wasn't a damn nightclub. Okay? I'm a good dad.
Speaking of good dad, that's hilarious. Now, you're behind the party anthem, turned down for what?
Yeah, I heard you. Give it up.
Yep, you heard me. But what I want to know, we talk, on this show, we talk a lot about perception and judging and discriminating based on first impressions and stuff. So we have a hip-hop superstar like you.
Right.
Okay. Who people perceive as a certain way. And you're out here with your son. And your son looks more like an Abercrombie and Fitch model than
he actually used to model.
There you go.
Yes,
okay,
right.
See, there you go. So what are some of the perceptions you both
get from people, and how do you deal with it and maybe, you know, combat it? Or
number one perception people have of me is that I'm always screaming! Yeah! Like this guy over here, he's screaming at me. This guy's screaming. I'm not always screaming, ladies and gentlemen. It's okay to say, hey, how you doing? All right, yeah.
So people just yell at you to come
all
up to you?
The time.
You look like in Target, just and trying to buy some paper towels.
Yeah, I could be in the stall in the bathroom and somewhere, and they just, yeah! Like, can I use the bathroom in peace, brother? You, so what about you?
You're little John now.
What about you?
I just get that I'm pretty chill. Yeah, I get the opposite.
I don't know how people can get that from you. That's so weird.
But you're Jonathan Smith at home.
Yes.
Yes, so there's no screaming and...
No.
Just some regular dad stuff.
I just want to lay on the couch. Like, when I come up...
Brother. Hey, can't we just... Please just lay on the couch.
Yeah, sometimes when the family's not home, I just sleep on the couch. I don't even go to the bedroom. I just stay
heaven.
On the couch.
My God. So DJ Young Slade, you becoming a DJ, how do you avoid the pitfalls of the party scene
and
Hollywood?
And the music industry. How do you stay focused? Because there's a lot of distractions out there.
Yeah, just my parents just keeping me grounded, making sure I'm always staying in the right places, just keeping me being strict.
Ah. There you go.
So you're
not the party dad, you're the strict dad.
I guess I try to be harder on him because as a producer and just the way I came up, I worked extra hard. So he's like naturally gifted. He's naturally talented. He started DJing at 11 years old. I don't know many 11-year-old DJs. Mm-hmm. He graduated from Scratch Academy, 12 years old?
Yeah.
He's naturally talented. So I have to kind of be harder on him because it's easy for him.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. I heard you made a pact that you would never miss a birthday.
Yeah.
Have you ever been faced with a difficult choice of
Wow. Yeah with Usher was,
hot.
Number one song of the, 2004, I think. And Usher was asked to come do Saturday Night Live. And he was like, yo, I got Luda on board. Can you come? And I was like, ugh, I can't go. It's my son's birthday. Saturday Night Live. Yeah.
Well, that's a tough one.
You know.
That is so good. That's a tough one. But, hey, that's incredible. I commend you for that.
Thanks.
Stick around, because when we come back, Lil Jon and DJ Young Slade are going to try really hard to beat Boris and I in a hip-hop challenge, because we know stuff.
With one of the hippest fathers, Lil Jon, and his son, DJ Young Slade. And we're about to challenge them in a game of Hip Hop Anonymous.
That's right, we got this. In order to be a world-renowned hip hop artist like Lil Jon, it's important to have a unique stage name. Well, I want a stage name. What's your mic?
Nicky Nick.
Nicky Nick!
Nicky Nick! What about me?
Gobo.
Gobo.
Gobo and Nicky Nick about to take them down. Hip-hop names, we have 9 other superstar faces who are missing their birth names.
Yep, and the object will be to match the name with the proper face.
We will have
30 seconds, and the person with the most hip-hop artists matching their proper birth name wins. And the losing team will have to record a 6-second Vine video complimenting the winning team.
Is everyone ready to play?
Yeah!
Yeah!
All right.
Okay.
5, 4...
Okay, can we get 30 seconds on the clock? And a horn to start!
Go!
Give me the guy's name. We done.
We're done. Who was done first?
Okay.
All right.
No, man.
All right.
All right.
Come on.
Okay. Let's check and see.
Okay, clearly, you stand over there. I'll do it. Here are the results. Let's see if we got this right. Number one.
The brat is
Shantae Harris.
Woo!
We got that right? And see if you got that right. Yes. What about on the other side? Shantae Harris. Okay, that's 1 point for you guys. Number two, Drake is Aubrey Graham.
We got it right. Did they get it right?
Did they get it right?
They got it right.
We got it.
Actually, Aubrey used to show up at the Soul Food set when he was 12 years old. He was one of the extras in the Soul Food set.
Wow.
That's right.
Number three, Big Daddy Kane, Antonio Hardy. We don't. What do you have? What do you have?
Did they get it right?
Oh, okay, that's one for you.
Why can't we give some applause for that?
Okay, Queen Latifah, a.k.a. Dana Elaine Owens. We got that right.
Amherst!
Yeah!
Okay.
I was rushing, man. Hey, pressure.
Okay, next, Wiz Khalifa is Cameron...
Jabril.
So you got that wrong?
Yeah, so we got...
We got that wrong. Man.
Yep.
What about you? You have that right?
We got that right.
Okay, then we got... Iggy Azalea is
Amethyst Kelly. We got that.
Amethyst Kelly, we got that right.
So we got that wrong.
Oh, you got that wrong.
Dana. Okay.
And the last one is Snoop Dogg, a.k.a. Calvin.
It's a tie, ain't it?
Broder
Jr. Oh,
it's a tie!
It's a tie!
That's all good.
I got it.
Okay.
It looks like we have a tie, so we got to do a 6-second vine praising them, and they got to do a 6-7 vine praising us. Yeah. All right.
Okay.
We'll go first.
Say it again.
Huh?
6-second vine?
Yeah. I'm right here. All right.
You ready?
Go Bulls and Nicky Nick. We not flow. We so slick. That's the wall. I can't lie. Please listen to his new single, Cutie Pie.
Hey!
Whoa. That was good.
That was crazy.
Why we got skills?
That was crazy. Your turn.
My hand again.
Bye.
Yes.
Your turn.
I love y'all.
You gotta praise us.
Oh, all right. Oh, damn. You gotta praise us.
We praise you.
Thank you, Boris. Thank you for your call for having us on your show. You guys are awesome. I can't top you. That was too good. I'm getting top
that. Little girl in the song, DJ Young Blade, for being such good sports.
Cooking, and I think I'm pretty fabulous in the kitchen, and so does he. And we're always trying to outdo each other. But today...
Today, we are finally putting our culinary skills to the test by creating the perfect summer dish in our mystery meal challenge. Now it's time for Nicole to put her spatula where her mouth is. Right? It's on and cracking.
And we've invited a celebrity chef to judge our culinary skills.
She's known as the rock star chef with an edge on her show, Bitchin' Kitchen. And she's the author of Cooking for Trouble. Please welcome Chef Nadia G.
Hey, hello, girl. Hello.
So, Nadia, what makes the perfect summer meal?
Well, for the perfect summer meal, it all depends on one thing, how drunk you are.
Whoa.
Yeah, I mean, if you've had a couple of drinks, you probably want something that's a deep fried, heavier, that'll coat your belly. If you're looking to look sexy in your bathing suit, then I guess you want something light. So it all kind of depends on what you're in the mood for.
Right. Well,
There's no such thing as a summer meal.
Where are you from?
Montreal.
Oh.
Yeah.
Montréal.
C'est sûr que je parle français. Toi aussi.
Pas de problème. Je suis allemand, mais...
Can we keep going?
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, do you have any tips before we get started?
Tips. Well, here's the thing. When you're in a competition show for cooking, you need to stick with what you know. This is not the time to like start cooking up a duck à l'orange or something crazy.
Ah, I was gonna do that.
Yeah, exactly.
Duck à l'orange.
Stick to what you know, and I wish you luck. I mean, you guys don't have much time.
Okay, I know, but so that's why we're gonna ask two people from the audience to assist us. June, Brittany, will you come on down?
June, Brittany, where are you?
June and Brittany.
Hey! Give it up for June and Brittany.
You're Brittany, you're gonna be with me. June, you're with Boris.
Get over here, June.
Yes.
Get over here.
Hello.
Put your apron on. It's right
here.
All right.
Yes, I have a little apron for you.
There it is. Nice to meet you. Nadia, can you tell us the rules?
Absolutely. So each team has 4 minutes to complete their mystery meal.
Oh, boy.
And you gotta make a main course and the dessert. So that's not a long time, folks. The one with the best dish is gonna win the Golden Utensil Award.
Nice. You just scared me a little bit.
All right, let's set the timer. And let's get cooking.
Okay. Get everything. Get everything. Push them away. Get away. Get the chicken. We need an onion, basil.
Hey, 4 minutes gonna go fast. You guys gotta pick it up. Pick it up.
Whole thing. Pick the whole thing. Turn on this thing. June. We need a saute.
So what's the idea here, ladies? What do we have going on?
Okay, well,
cutting the chicken.
I don't want to give them any clues because my husband tries to listen and cheat.
Yes. Well, I think he's got a lot on his plate right now, but it looks like
we're gonna do a movie.
Now here's one tip I got for you. You're really gonna want to taste that jalapeno.
I know, I like
because they vary, right? You can get a hot pepper that's not hot at all, and then you can get some that will surprise you the next day, not in a good way. Let's see what's going on over here.
That's good.
What are you folks making?
She is sauteing glazing.
I'm gonna tell you something. That's some big chunks of onion in 3 minutes.
Come on, June.
I would
smaller,
kinda cut those a little smaller.
It would be hotter. Sorry.
Okay.
Here we got spinach.
We got some spinach. Put some spinach in there too. Okay, this has to be smaller. All right. Come on, sous chef.
My bad. Bacon.
All right, we got the chocolate.
Delicious.
I'm gonna make the dessert.
Now mine.
While you chop.
You also have to make a dessert.
Chopping the broccoli.
So you want to start thinking about that.
Oh my God.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I'm
gonna get the almonds.
Okay, I'm so focused, I'm forgetting to talk.
That's right.
And this is a talk show.
You have 1 minute and 40 seconds left.
I know how to cook
chicken
under pressure. You want to know why?
Throw the chicken
in there. Because when you got two kids and a hungry man, you got to figure out how to do that fast. Don't lose no pasta, girl.
garlic, June,
she's
garlic.
A good chef.
For God's sake, garlic.
I got it.
This.
Okay, I'm making a special Kodjoe.
I need a dessert.
Chocolate
plate.
Dessert.
That's all right.
With whipped cream.
I'm just going to scoop it right back on it.
Yeah, these onions are really not fried.
June. It's
okay. We'll get a bit of crunch going on in there. That's for
sure. Come on, June.
Yeah.
You can do it, June. You can do it, June.
Yes, texture, she says.
A little chocolate.
Texture.
Some basil, maybe, right?
A little whipped cream around this.
I'm going to put a little
there you go.
Oreo.
Look at how beautiful
crumble.
This looks. This is a chocolate.
Do you have a name for this dish?
This is a chocolate souffle.
It could be
whipped cream cake.
I'll tell you.
In a bowl.
Skeleton in a bowl. So what are you making over here?
That's good.
Simple and delicious where you can't go wrong. I have little kids, so I know how to do this.
Cheese grater. Where's the cheese grater?
Oh, you put some bacon.
There's a cheese grater right here.
Have you thought of a fancy name for this dish?
I think we're done.
Yeah, this dish is called the improv. This is perfect.
Time's up. Let's see what each team has created.
Okay. Boris and June?
Yes, we're ready. We're ready.
Ladies, what have we got here?
Oh, we'll go first. Okay. Yes. I love the fact that you brought us some rotini pasta. Can't go wrong, right? So it was already cooked, but we made it shiny and smooth and sauteed some garlic and with some olive oil.
You made it shiny.
Yes, because sometimes pasta can be dull.
It's true. Shiny pasta is better than dull pasta.
Right.
That I agree with 100%.
You told me presentation.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Exactly. No, this actually looks really good. Let me taste it.
Oh, boy. You better watch out.
Gotta get a little bit of everything.
That's right, a little bit.
And I just crumbled the bacon, because they were good and crispy.
All right, that's a nice looking forkful.
Oh boy.
I think this is delicious.
Whoa.
Good, simple pasta. The bacon adds a ton of flavor. I mean, when in doubt, add bacon.
It's a little bit of saltiness,
honestly.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Where's
very nice.
Juice? Where's the bacon juice?
So what did they do over there in their pasta?
The
well, let's take a look over here. Let's see what the flavor's like in this.
Well, the flavor sometimes is overrated. So it's really just about, it's about the thought that goes into it and the love and the heart. Exactly, June. You're right.
Well, I'm gonna eat this.
You're gonna put a love and family on
there. Spinach leaf here, exactly.
I don't know if you wanna eat the leaves. It's very. Are you okay?
Can you take a commercial break so I can keep chewing?
Oh, what? Nadia, you're killing me over here. Come on.
It's gonna take time to chew this.
We're running out of time. Taste
what's going on here?
It's a chocolate cake with whipped cream and almonds and some. Inside marmalade, jelly.
Yeah. Let's whipped get cream it all and jelly.
Whipped cream and jelly.
I still haven't. It was
what
so dry.
What are you commenting on
I
my stuff?
Have been slow.
Huh?
Oh, yeah, good. I like this.
All right, yeah. All right.
Hey, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Thank you.
Here's mine. No.
There you go. She can't stop.
Very good.
Kid, I only put a little dollop of chocolate under the whipped cream.
Dollop? What is dollop?
Dollop's a great word.
Don't you worry. And then you sprinkle the Oreo. I used half an Oreo.
Half an Oreo. See, I like this. This is good presentation. This is good presentation.
That is brown nosery. That's what that is. Look at that.
See, the Oreo adds a little bit of crunch, which is nice.
Crunch?
Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm serious. And the strawberry, that's always good with a bit of chocolate. Have good texture?
This ain't nothing.
Well, for the best taste, and what do we got here?
All right. For the best taste and overall presentation, the winner is Ulytis!
Special thanks to Chef Nadia G for helping us out today.
There you
go. That's your great teammate, June Brittany.
And for you, Boris, second place.
To go on the Boris and Nicole show. Stay tuned. Tune in now.
Thank you. Welcome back. The one thing most people don't know about our next guest is that he's actually a singer-rapper, and his first single, Love, is dropping this summer. See, most people know him as the vulnerable and troubled Bunchy on Showtime's Ray Donovan. Take a look.
I ran your credit card 3 times. It's no good.
Look, our last promoter didn't pay us. We don't even have a venue right now. Work with us.
You gotta pay the train.
Oh, come on, man.
Sorry.
Please help us welcome my man with the coolest name in Hollywood, Dash Mihok.
Hello there.
How you doing, Dash?
Oh, just so I come out and shoot the breeze a little bit.
See?
You and I, we understand each other.
You know, just saying.
See, Dash, I gotta tell you, my wife has this thing about people's dialects and accents. Mm-hmm. So when she talks to somebody with a certain dialect, she immediately takes on that accent or that dialect. Like, instantaneously.
It's
everywhere.
Hard. I do it, too. Whenever I go back to New York, I get more New York. Whenever I'm...
In the South,
you start getting the southern twang. I do it too. I'm
unbelievable.
I know.
Right here, but you're also a rapper.
I'm a rapper.
There you go.
So you know.
Did you meet Lil Jon?
I didn't meet Lil Jon.
Are you serious?
I know. Oh. I was in my room, I guess, and I didn't get my pose with him. I also didn't bring my grill or anything today.
See, yeah, he's got a grill, but other than that, he looks like a like some dude from a country club. I mean, yeah, he's got the pink polo shirt on.
He was rocking the Hamptons. Hair.
He's got
for sure.
Yeah, I know the Hamptons.
How do you get? How did you get into rapping?
You know, when I was 12 years old, I had that's like a long time ago. I had this rap group, Sam Dash Chris, Strictly Devastating Crew, in junior high school. And I
Hold on.
Yeah.
Can you repeat that, please?
Sam Dash Chris, those are the three members. Strictly Devastating Crew. Now, in the 80s, that was hot. Telling you.
SDC.
SDC.
SDC in the house.
I've always flirted with it, and I've been writing songs for so many years, and people have been at me like, yo, you need to put it out and do this.
Absolutely.
Now.
Well, let's see how far you've come with SDC. We have a clip of your new single that's coming out this summer. Take a look.
Oh, this is amazing. Wow. What? Single coming out
Valeria Mason
has an album out on iTunes. Go check it. It's Latin. She's Latin.
I gotta admit, I'm obsessed with your show.
Yes,
Ray Donovan.
Woo!
Anybody watch the show?
I mean, yes.
It's the most incredible show. Yes. And your character, Bunchy, is off the chain. He's a mess. What did you have to do to get into that character?
Drink a lot. Mainly when I'm acting my personal way, I just really, it's make-believe, you know? So I do as much research as I can, and then I just imagine what it would be like to be struggling with, you know,
those
not
issues.
Trying to drink and those issues, yeah.
Yeah. So.
Well, changing gears a little bit,
okay.
You are a supporter of Tourette Syndrome Association.
I am.
You were diagnosed at age 6.
I was.
And you have lived with it, and you work through it every day. Can you tell us about it?
Yeah, it's funny. I love being in front of these kind of shows because there's all this light on you. One of my tics is I have to look at the light and like do this twitch thing. So I don't know. I'm in the wrong business, people.
Hysterical.
There's lights everywhere every day.
That's amazing. But is there a dialogue that goes on in your head?
There is, you know, I was diagnosed as I was a kid, and it's unfortunately it's a lot worse when you're a kid. It usually subsides a little bit more as an adult. But the great thing about acting is I get to when my mind and body and spirit are all focused on portraying that character, I don't tick. I always say I can make a movie, but it's hard to watch one. Because when I'm sitting here at rest, that's when the tics come on. But when I'm in the middle of stuff, that's when I don't tick.
So what would you tell a young kid that is struggling with Tourette's in terms of achieving their goals or if maybe even become an actor?
I would say tell people. Tell people, alleviate the stress of having people not know what's going on with you. The more they know, the more they'll accept you. And know that you have a gift, too. You know, with Tourette's, it stretches you in a lot of different ways. It makes you use muscles that other people that don't have it might not be able to train.
Yeah.
So there's a gift in there somewhere. Remember that we all have a gift, and it's in there. Just love yourself.
You just helped a lot of people. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dash Mihok, for stopping by today. Be sure to catch him on Ray Donovan Sunday nights on Showtime.
For more information on Tourette syndrome, go to our Facebook page. We'll be right back. All right, welcome back. Because we've been married for 10 years, a lot of people ask us for relationship advice. And we love helping whenever we can. So we've received so many questions from you on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. So we're here to answer some of your questions. It's time for
Hey Nicole! Our first question is from Megan in Ohio, who's joining us via Skype. Hi, Megan.
Hi, Megan.
Hey Nicole.
Hi, what's your question?
Hi, so my name is Megan, of course, and my husband and I just recently moved from Mount Juliet, Tennessee to Cleveland, Ohio.
Yes.
We have four beautiful children, a 10-year-old, 4-year-old, and a set of twins that are 2. Oh. And we have no family, no friends up here, so we get no downtime. We have no babysitter. Yeah. So I'm just looking for some tips on how to keep our relationship fun and kind of spicy, because we get no downtime from the kiddos.
Where are the kids right
now? I like
that
she said downtime. She's not getting any downtime.
Where'd you put the kids? You're sitting there by yourself.
No, they're with my 10-year-old in the other room. I had to bribe them.
The 10-year-old is watching the other three?
But just in the other room, though.
Do you smell smoke? Because if they're too quiet, you know what that means, right?
I have candy. They have candy.
They're good. Good. They're
candy's good.
She needs help with her husband.
Oh, wow. Okay, what I'm thinking here, Megan, is that you and your husband just need to face the music, which is you got four kids under 10, which is insanity. And I applaud you. She should get an Emmy nomination. Yes. At least. Okay? So in that case, when you don't have any help at all, you have to make use of the time after their sleep. When they go to sleep, that's when your date starts. Whether it's just a blanket on the floor in your bedroom with some wine and cookies and whatever, or whether
that's
it's just
really
a TV date. Yeah, you gotta be resourceful.
You never did this with me?
Well, because we had a babysitter. Oh. We were lucky. We had a babysitter. So just make use of that time, because when you have four kids without any help, it's crazy. But you have to make time for your husband somehow.
But I like the whole everybody go in the other room, give him some candy. I wouldn't recommend this in any other situation. Turn on all the TVs, go in your bedroom, and lock the door.
Thank you, Megan. Look, we don't have all the answers, but it's good to talk about it.
Yes.
So keep those questions coming, please. Go to twitter.com/BorisandNicole with the hashtag #HeyBacole. Can the audience say that? #HeyBacole. There you go.
We'll be right back.
The weekend.
You have to change your phone number now.
Okay, yes, well, I
Where's
guess
your
I.
Phone?
Okay, I fulfilled my phone? End of the bet with Rick Fox. I spoke with lots of you on the phone, received your texts.
And your pictures. Yes. Thank you very much for the pictures.
Okay. And I also listened to your voicemail. So thank you so much for all your love, and I appreciate you all, but I'm ready for my phone to stop ringing.
You and me both.
Okay.
It's been a very interesting week for sure, but I can't be mad at you, ladies.
Okay, look.
Because I love them too.
All right. So before we kick off the weekend, we want to thank Little John and his son, DJ Young Slade, Nadia G, and my man, Dash Mihok, for hanging out with us today.
And we want to thank all of you for spending the week with us. Make sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Instagram. We'll see you right back here on Monday.
Bye. Transportation provided by Jackson Limousine.